One day, a normal 44-year-old man, leading a normal life and father of two children, starts to feel uncomfortable. He ignores it for a while, but then he goes to the doctor and tries to find out the cause of his discomfort. The doctors do a physical examination of the patient, but they can't find anything wrong. Finally, they take a CT scan of the man's brain in case there is something wrong with it. The results are unbelievable. The doctors are surprised because this is the first time in their careers that they have encountered such a situation. 90% of the man's brain is missing. So how will the scientific world explain this? How is it possible for a person without a brain to live? And how is it possible for a person without a brain to come to the hospital by himself as if it were a normal disease? If someone asked you, "Is it possible to live without a brain?" most people who are unaware of these cases would probably scoff at the question and say, "You cannot live without a brain." However, the brain, the most mysterious organ that controls human beings, astonishes the scientific world with such cases. Before I continue with the video, I would like to make a request. Our channel is new and our current target is 1,000 subscribers. If you like interesting and scientific topics, please subscribe to the channel and support us by giving us likes. Normally, there are fluid-filled brain ventricles in the center of the brain, occupying an area of about 2%. However, in the brain of the person in question, these ventricles are extremely enlarged, taking up 90% of the brain. Because of this, the brain tissue was extremely enlarged and crushed between the cavities and the hard skull, causing the brain to weigh about 300 grams instead of 1.4 kilograms. Experts attribute this person's survival and ability to lead a normal life to the slow development of the pressure increase. Over the years, as brain tissue was slowly crushed and shrunk, healthy functions were transferred to neighboring regions, and these regions took over all the skills important to human. This adaptation shows how complex, flexible, and resilient the brain is. Man with iron stuck in his head. As you can see from the name of the case, the man we are about to describe was more unlucky than other cases, because the accident he had changed not only his brain, but his whole life and character. In the late 1800s in the United States, a man named Phineas Gage was working as a railroad worker in the United States. Gage was a good man, loved by his friends, skilled at his work, and devoted to his family. One day, while working on a railroad construction site, he was placing explosive materials on the ground. A brief argument with his co-workers distracted him, and a sudden explosion caused a 1-meter-long stake to go through his left eye and out the top of his head. Everyone thought Gage was dead, but he didn't realize much except that he was blind in his left eye. At first, we thought he was unlucky, but a small bullet in the head is supposed to kill you instantly. But the stake that pierced Phineas Gage's head didn't kill him. Far from killing him, he even asked everyone after the incident, "Why are you looking at me like that?" After the accident, Gage was taken to the hospital where doctors dressed him and ran various tests. "I have to record this. I've never seen anything like this in my life," said the doctor when he saw that his basic skills were fine. Within 2 weeks, the man began to make an astonishing recovery, but exhibited strange behavior. Gage, once an admired, self-disciplined, and good family man, was gone, replaced by a man with no morals and no sense of shame. He was no longer ashamed to even use the toilet in the streets. So why did this man lose his human qualities even though he survived? Rare but similar cases, such as the Gage case, have been recorded since the 19th century, and such cases have been studied to understand how humans can reach such a conclusion. Studies have shown that the frontal region of the brain governs the qualities that make us human, such as will control, moral values, and impulse control. If this area is damaged or congenitally weak, it can lead to serious difficulties in following human rules. The man who stuck his head in a particle accelerator, his name is Anatoly Bugorsky. In 1978, the 36-year-old Bugorsky, a researcher at the Protvino Institute of High Energy Physics in Russia, suffered a rare accident while checking a malfunctioning particle accelerator. Not realizing that safety precautions had been disabled, Bugorski stuck his head inside the accelerator, and a beam of protons traveling at almost the speed of light entered the back of his head and exited through his nose. He felt no pain at the time, and only for a moment saw a light as bright as the sun. Interestingly, he didn't immediately tell anyone. Bugorski guessed that what had happened to him was bad, and that he might be in serious trouble in the coming hours, but he decided to wait a little longer. By nightfall, however, the left side of his face was swollen, and he realized that he should go to the doctor first thing in the morning. Doctors admitted Anatoly Bugorski to a clinic in Moscow specializing in the treatment of radiation poisoning. Tests revealed that Bugorski had been exposed to 2,000 to 3,000 gray radiation. This is a dose high enough to kill a person within days. In fact, even 4 to 10 gray radiation can be fatal. However, Bugorski did not die. The radiation he was exposed to was a focused beam, so it did not affect his entire body. The proton beam destroyed nerves and tissues in the areas it passed through. As a result, half of his face was paralyzed, he lost his hearing, and suffered seizures. Despite this, he returned to work after 18 months. His mental abilities were not diminished. He completed his PhD and continued to work as a coordinator of physics experiments at the U-70 proton synchrotron, where the accident took place. Baby born with brainstem. This baby, Nicholas Koch, suffered from a rare condition known as anencephaly, which means he was born with only one brain stem. While most children with this condition die shortly after birth, Nicholas was the only child to live for as long as 3 years. What's more, he lived his life without being hooked up to any medical machines, and in the process captured the attention of the scientific community. Although medical experts admit that children with anencephaly cannot think or have emotions, his family said that he laughed because he found some of our actions funny. Nicholas, who was nourished by his family's love and care every day of his life, sadly died after 3 years and was recorded as a miraculous case. This interesting story is about a chicken who, unlike a human being, lost not only his brain, but his whole head, but still lived. In the 40s, many farmers made a living selling eggs, milk, chicken, and canned goods. On September 10, 1945, Lloyd Olson and his wife Clara were slaughtering chickens to sell at market on their farm in Colorado. But one of the 40 or 50 animals exposed to Olson's axe that day did not behave like the others. After cutting off its head, a rooster stood up and started running around. Not surprised at first and thinking that such things are short-lived during slaughter, the couple decided to see how long they could keep it alive when they realized the rooster was still alive the next morning. Soon, word spread through the neighborhood and people started coming to see the headless rooster at the Olson farm. They named him Mike, and suddenly he was famous in all the magazines. When scientists examined the rooster, they found that part of the ear, the carotid artery, and the base of the brain, which controls motor functions, remained intact and were able to live because they had not lost too much blood. But in any case, countless chickens have been decapitated and none of them have been able to live normally like Mike. The real death of Mike the rooster, who became an instant celebrity and earned his owners 18 months of income in circuses, was the result of an accident. Mike sometimes started choking and needed help to clear his throat. In this case, a special syringe was used to clear his throat and save him from drowning. However, one night while the owners were resting in the motel room for tomorrow's show, Mike started to choke, but they forgot the bulb syringe to clear his throat somewhere else, and Mike died within minutes. Thus, this rare event, which took place as a result of coincidence, made history in the world of science. Now, going back to the question, could we live without our brain? The general answer is, of course, that we couldn't, because the brain stem, which is one of the parts of the organ we call the brain, is a very ancient structure that now controls your breathing, heartbeat, blood pressure, and swallowing reflex. So if this part does not exist, you cannot exist. However, if somehow, with the exception of this part, the rest of the body is damaged, there is a very rare chance of survival, as we have seen from the cases we have mentioned. An in-depth study of this topic shows how limited what we know about the brain is and how the complexity of this organ continues to amaze us every day. The plasticity of the brain offers a promising area of research where even people who have suffered a stroke or severe brain damage can regain some of their functions over time. Also, as we have mentioned in previous videos, some companies, most notably Neuralink, are currently carrying out important projects to make the brain more functional. For example, they are working on potential applications such as helping paralyzed individuals to regain movement, alleviating the symptoms of Parkinson's patients, or restoring the cognitive functions of people with memory loss. The success of such projects holds great promise for humanity in the future.